In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Christ is in our midst. Trust in the Lord with all your heart, and lean not to your own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he will direct your paths. Trust in the Lord with all your heart, and lean not to your own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he will direct thy paths. We read today in the gospel that ultimately the Lord takes care of those who seek him. The Lord will guide you. The Lord will lead you. The Lord will give you every needful thing. Seek first the kingdom of God and all and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. God, if God is first, if our hearts are open to him, and if we seek to obey him, if we seek his righteousness, if we seek the Lord, all that we need in one way or another will be provided by God. That's what the lesson is today in the gospel lesson, and it's a very strong one. The Lord knows we need to eat. The Lord knows we need a place to live. The Lord knows we need clothing. Those things are very, very important. Of course they're important. But we get weighed down with worrying about that. He says, do not worry. Seek me. Seek me first, and everything that you need will be given to you. That's what he says. Consider the lilies of the field, they neither toil nor spin, yet Solomon in all his glory was not arrayed like one of these, which I think is one of the most beautiful verses in Scripture. Consider the lilies of the field. They neither toil nor spin. But Solomon, in all of his glory, was not arrayed like one of these. Who could put a sentence like that together? Only Christ. Because it speaks to one of the deepest worries of man, one of the greatest anxieties that man has, and it answers it saying, your Father in heaven will take care of you. But we must seek first the kingdom of God and his, Christ's righteousness, and all these things will be added unto us. We cannot serve God and mammon. We can't serve God. We can't serve two masters. You either serve God or you serve mammon. What's mammon? It's just going after stuff, is what it is. It's loving everything but God. And when you don't love God, you love the things of this world. But the things of this world cannot nourish the soul. Nourishing the soul is our first priority, seeking God and his righteousness. All the other stuff that we need for living will be given to us if we seek God. If we try and serve God and mammon, we're going to hate the one, we're going to love the one, and despise the other. So if you love mammon, you're going to despise God. Think about that. If you love mammon, you're going to despise God. If you love God, you're not going to be a slave to mammon, because mammon doesn't love you back, but God does. We can't serve two masters. And given the way the world is going, you've heard me say this before, and you're going to hear me say it a lot, the age of lukewarm Christianity is over. You're going to be either hot or you're going to be cold. There's no room there's not. And so our trust and faith in God has to deepen if we are going to be his disciples. Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not to your own understanding. That means don't try and figure it all out yourself. Trust God. In all thy ways, acknowledge him, and he shall direct your paths. That comes from the very mouth of God. It's a direct quote from Jesus, is what it is. It's the transformative word, and it's truth, because nothing is more certain in this world than the word of God himself. So, through the prayers of our holy fathers, may the Lord have mercy on us and save us. Amen.